What is up guys, Faded here and welcome back to my channel for another video, and today I wanted to tell you about something very special, and that is the i7-5820K. Yes, the i7-5820K, which is not expected for release until this Friday, but thanks to Amazon's little glitch they had on Monday, I was able to jump in, buy it, and get it delivered this morning on the 27th. Now, I wanted to go ahead and do an unboxing video, tell you guys a little bit about what's in the box, and also say just a little bit about the specs and what's on the net about it. Now, I don't have the motherboard yet. That's going to be coming either this weekend or sometime next week, and I'll have a full review up on this chip as soon as I possibly can. Now, the frequency comes in at 3300 megahertz with a boost clock of 3600 megahertz, and that's using turbo technology 2.0. Now this is an unlock multiplier, so you are able to overclock it as much as you like. All these new Haswell chips are going to be able to do that, so that's really awesome. That's probably why they did not offer a CPU cooler that comes with it, because people are going to be overclocking from the beginning and using third-party hardware and not having anything to do with the stock cooler. So anyways, I got this for $394, $395. You can check the Amazon link here on the screen. See that I actually really did get it from Amazon. You can see the price that I ordered it at. Now, while I'm thinking of it, this does have 6 cores, and that's 12 threads total. So that's 6 regular cores and then 6 virtual cores. It does not have an integrated GPU, so you're going to have to get a dedicated GPU if you want, you know, visuals and you want a game and all that stuff. And lastly, it has 15 megabytes of level 3 cache, so that's going to be awesome. It's a lot more than the last Haswell chip, so I'm really excited to see how this card works out, or this chip works out. So anyways guys, I hope you liked the video. If you liked it, click that like button. If you dislike it, click the dislike button. I hope you guys subscribe. I look forward to having you post in the comments and tell me what you'd like to see in the review, you know, what kind of test you want me to do. I'm thinking about doing a 4770K versus 5820K. If you'd like to see that, let me know. And anyways, guys, you guys have a good one.